In this video, I'll talk about how to supercharge your smart contracts with OpenZeppelin. OpenZeppelin provides tools to write, deploy, and operate decentralized applications. There are two different products that OpenZeppelin provides, the contracts library and the SDK. I'll visit their website, openzeppelin.com, to explore more. At openzeppelin.com, I can learn lots of helpful information to get me started about OpenZeppelin and learning what I can do with the two products that it offers. If I scroll down on the homepage, I can get to where they feature the two products available, and this is a great place to learn more. So with the contracts library, this is a set of modular, reusable, well-tested contracts that are used very widely in the blockchain enterprise community. Here you can get a set of different contracts from math to tokens to gas station network, other utilities that are very, very helpful at integrating into current or new smart contract projects. To get started with the contracts library, you can use the Node Package Manager to install and instantly start using the OpenZeppelin contracts. The SDK provides a suite of tools to help you develop, test, upgrade, and deploy contracts, all from the command line. So there are really helpful tools to kind of help you interact with your contracts and with your smart contracts library or project in general. So I want to explore more about these two products in particular and demonstrate how to get started and use them. The best place to learn more, if you just want to read up, is to actually visit the docs site. So at docs.openzeppelin.com, I can see lots of helpful information as well as learning modules if I want to follow some tutorials to help me kind of get started. If I look at the CLI project, also known as the SDK, I can also learn a lot of information about basically how to get started with this project and how to learn more. So next I'll show how to get started with these two tools over in my terminal. So to get started, I will make a new project directory that I can use to demonstrate OpenZeppelin. To do that, I can say make dir openzeppelin-test. And let's go ahead now and cd to that test directory. Once I'm there, I want to immediately install the OpenZeppelin contracts project. So what I can do is say npm install at openzeppelin-contracts. Don't worry, we can't see all of that. Hopefully I did type the right thing, and this will go ahead and start to install that package for me. So right off the bat, I do get an error, and that is okay. I get an error because it says no such file or directory package.json. So one thing that's helpful and good to know is that when I'm trying to create install a new Node package, it would be helpful if I had somewhere to store the package. So something that I can do is use the Node Package Manager to initialize this project as a Node project. And let's say npm init. And I can walk through the tool here to go ahead and set up information about the package. And I'm just going to use the default information for much of this. And is this okay? Yes. So I can just follow that installation wizard. And I want to now try to install this OpenZeppelin contracts package again. And this time I can see that it was successfully installed. So I installed version 3.2.0. And now let me do an ls to see the contents of my project. So I have a package.json, which I just created through the help of that installer tool, the npm init. And I also have node modules. And let's go ahead and look in the node modules. And you'll notice that I have these OpenZeppelin node modules available to me. So if I do an ls node modules at OpenZeppelin, what I should be able to see there now is contracts. And then within this contracts library, I will have all the contracts available to me that are part of OpenZeppelin. So there's lots of different contracts there that I can start to explore with. And if I just go one more level in, we should see all those contracts. So I have gas station network, GSN, access contracts, cryptography, introspection, math, payment, and more. So right, just from installing the contracts library or package, you have all of those contracts available in your project that you can easily begin to integrate with. So now let me go back up to the root of my project. Maybe that was too far. And now that I'm back here, what I want to demonstrate next is how to use that SDK, or rather CLI, so I can start to interact with OpenZeppelin from my terminal itself. So to do that, I can type npm install at openzeppelin/CLI. And then I can just wait a moment for that to go ahead and install the package to my project. Okay, and after a few minutes, that installs successfully. I do have some vulnerabilities that are a part of the project, and that's something that you'll want to look out for, but generally it's okay since I'm just using this to test out with. So now what I can do is start to look at all of the commands that the CLI provides. To do that, I can type npx oz. Oz is OpenZeppelin for short. And after I do that, I can see a list of all the different commands that I can use with OpenZeppelin CLI. And I'm just scrolling through the commands because there are quite a lot of different ones that I can do, from viewing accounts, to adding contracts, to querying the balance, compiling, and more. So let's go ahead and try a simple command now, just to try things out. So I'm going to use the command npx oz, and let's go ahead and try out compile and see what happens there. And that's fine, no contracts to compile. That might be normal since there are no contracts actually. So this is a time where I might want to integrate with a tool like Truffle to help in initialize my project, give me some initial contracts and migrations to get started. And just to goes to show that you can really start to combine some of these tools like OpenZeppelin and Truffle to really supercharge your development. So that's all that I basically want to show with how easy it is to install the contracts and the SDK products into a sample smart contracts project.